on education. What Barack Obama said is they made great progress on education and health care.
Well, self-proclaimed socialist Bernie Sanders doubling down on his defense of communist Cuba. But with attacks coming from all angles, should Bernie maybe rethink his stance on the Castro regime? Joining us now to debate, Executive Director for the American Principles Project, Terry Schilling, and former Congressional Press Secretary Rochelle Ritchie. Thank you both for joining us. We really appreciate it this morning.
Good morning.
Thanks, man.
So let's start with this. This is President Obama praising some of Castro's progress.
I said this to President Castro in Cuba. I said, look, you've made great progress. Every child in Cuba gets a basic education. That's a huge improvement from where it was.
So I bring that up because that's obviously what Bernie Sanders was referencing last night. Rochelle, I'll begin with you. Your take on it.
Well, you know, I think Biden answered that question and made it very clear that although Obama did make those, I guess if you want to call them compliments towards Castro, he then turned around and criticized him. So I don't think that we can take that Bernie Sanders can actually take that and make it seem as though he and Obama are on the same page when it comes to someone like Castro. Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, Terry, you know, we had President Obama sitting there doing this interview with ESPN just hours after the terrorist attack in Brussels. We had him at the same time doing this wave at the baseball game with Castro. What do you think?
Look, the problem with Democrats is that they cozy up to these vicious and violent dictators like Fidel Castro and the Venezuelan regime, and they always defend them. And let's be very clear, when they mention things like Fidel Castro's literacy program or his education program, what they're really talking about is an indoctrination program. Fidel Castro was an oppressive dictator and a terrible leader. The number that I'm going to throw out right now is 141,000. That's how many people died at the hands of Fidel Castro. And so when Bernie Sanders says that he's a democratic socialist and that he's not a communist, you got to keep in mind, he's cozying up to people like this and praising them. And so it makes you wonder what he wants to do here in America.
Rochelle?
Can I respond to that really quickly? I just want to make it clear that it is not Democrats that are saying that Castro is this great person. This was a comment made
Bernie Sanders. Obama defended Castro all the way. He went down to Maduro in Venezuela.
I'm not going to get into a whole discussion about Castro because a lot of Democrats have come out and condemned the comments that Bernie Sanders made. And again, Obama went on to criticize Castro.
But then at the same time, you also,
Trump, who was cozying up to Kim Jong-un.
But then you also had Biden specifically saying that Hosni Mubarak should not step down in Egypt. So, you know, you can kind of spread it around in terms of the Democratic Party. And then you had Elizabeth Warren last night out of the gate defending, Bernie and alleging that he was more of a progressive and not really using the word socialism. Let's talk about Bloomberg, though, because Bloomberg did return to the debate stage. Some say with a vengeance last night. The question is, did he do enough to redeem himself? So listen to this, and then I'll get Rochelle, you to respond first.
I'm the one choice that makes some sense. I have the experience, I have the resources, and I have the record. Putin thinks that Donald Trump should be president of the United States, and that's why Russia is helping you get elected, so you'll lose to him. They talked about 40 Democrats. 21 of those were people that I spent $100 million to help elect.
Yeah, some of his jokes fell a little flat last night, Rochelle, in terms of the timing, at least.
Yeah, I think he should probably stay out of comedy and just stay in business and running for president. Look, I think that Bloomberg did a much better job last night. Is it going to be enough to win South Carolina? I do not think so. I think that the comment made by Elizabeth Warren when she said something about kill it, when she was talking about an incident where a female employee said that he had made this comment to her about when she was pregnant, and I went and I actually looked at Bloomberg, and I looked at their maternity policy now, they actually have 26 weeks of maternity leave, whether you're a man or a woman. And I think that's pretty incredible. And I think we need to stop talking about what happened in the past and talking about more about what we're going to do moving forward.
Terry, final.
Look, I think Bloomberg's a very weak candidate for the general election. What we have to keep in mind is that Bernie's momentum is not slowing. He's going up in the polls, not down. And if he goes into that convention with the most delegates and Mike Bloomberg ends up trying to buy this thing off and wins it outside of the convention, it's going to be an unmitigated disaster for Democrats in November.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. All right, thank you both for joining us. We appreciate
it. Thanks, Heather.
All right, have a great day.